Ice, what it do?
Dark Mars all on me, I'm just honest.
Hey, what it do?
Rockstar, my swag, I'm just honest.
Hey, what it do?
Everything is out of gun, just honest. Gold all of my neck, I'm just honest.
Hey, what it do?
Yeah,
I'm just honest. Right there. It's about to go down.
Let me tell you,
Father, I see you.
The life
I tell you, do a lot of running.
Oh, I love it. I love it. All right, guys, just woke up. Made a quick stop out in Virginia. Kerry and Fabe, they came to check one of their boys. You can see them back there. But I really want to show y'all the inside of this Ram, this Dodge Ram that we're taking. This shit is huge in here. Like, I'm laying down to sleep in here comfortably. Like, I believe this is a 2020. Dodge Ram. You got your stuff. You got the motor and the all-wheel drive parts right there. They over there looking at some. Oh shit! Matter of fact, you see that car over there? Let me go check that out.
Black Chevy. It's in pink.
Who the fuck does it do? You think it's this shit clean as hell though? This shit is clean, boy. Fuck, this shit is clean. Damn.
I don't know, Brooke.
It's so clean in here. Damn. Looks nothing like. Nothing like, I don't want to finish what I was going to say, man. Sheesh, so much room. Damn, look at this shit. I know in the beginning, all I said was that Kerry sold his all-wheel drive setup, but I never really said where I was going. I said we were going on a road trip. We're actually on our way to Florida right now to meet up with an actually pretty known YouTuber who bought this all-wheel drive setup from Kerry. We just made this quick stop out here in Virginia, and I didn't even know we was gonna stop out here, but if you see the last video I posted where there was an accident on the highway, that car that spun out, While he was spinning, he hit Kerry boosted EG, and I think he hit the quarter panel and he messed, like, the car is done. So we actually stopped out here at one of the friends. I didn't even know he knew a guy out here in Virginia. And he's picking up a new motor. And yeah, I think that's it. New motor, suspension. But yeah.
300 somebody out miles away from New York City in a hot ass sun. Dropping the motor. Watch your back.
So it turns out, actually I was wrong. He's actually buying that motor over there out of that Civic to replace the motor over here that he's selling. So now we leaving Norfolk, Virginia, and we're on our way to
Varis, Florida.
To Varis, Florida. This is nice. Shit. Damn.
So how long have you been driving? So what else are you guys delivering?
Well, we picked that up in Virginia, and we're probably going to hang out down here a day just to enjoy the sun, but it's up to an hour time. And your state is actually open.
Nothing really closed around here.
So we're going to actually just hang out. I tried to do the front, but you got to, like, mill it down, so yeah. I was like, I'm not even going to mess with
it. No, that's fine.
So wave track was going to be the next step.
I'm not looking for any sort of big power with this. Yeah. It's just going to be real.
I didn't lock up the rear or anything. The viscous is rebuilt. It's pretty fresh. Once you open the boxes, clean and shit, low mileage. Okay. It was a very low mileage wagon.
Yeah.
So, as I told you, the head is the full for a valve set competition. I did Super Tech Springs and Taylors. I had the whole head three angle valve job.
Mm-hmm.
It's a K-tune. Always need a relocator. Oh, that's brand new. Everything is idle, raw, throttle body, sculpture manifold, 1 liter spacer. I did the drag cartel timing chain hold. I changed the guides, the chain, everything.
For the oil return, where does that usually go?
Well, the oil return is okay on the front.
Uh-huh.
I capped it off for you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Right here. Okay.
The reason why I ran into the front is because, like, if you do let the half shaft go, like, I got a broken half shaft in it. It always
flies. Guys, this is Eric. He tunes some of my cars. Good friend of mine.
How's it going, man?
Hey.
Eric, nice to meet you.
I didn't know you had company, man.
Oh, no. How's it going? Just got here.
Hey, how's it going?
Nice to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, man.
First.
Yeah, I'm getting in the Honda game. So, I got some Hondas. So.
Oh, man. Like, the arms my boy did for me. Mm-hmm. So. The rear shoulder arms he did, so, like, we had a spot that works for NASA out in next to his job called Linda Tools.
Okay, very cool.
They basically cut the hubs out for us with a lathe and everything. So the arms are straight. That's like, it took me a good 2 weeks to get each arm.
Oh, yeah, basically. Dude, I know how it feels to get, like, custom stuff, and yeah, it's a thing. Well, I mean, when I saw your listing and I was like, this is pretty much everything I need, I was like, how much for all of it? So.
Yeah,
the only thing I didn't need is a turbo, because I'm not going for big power.
I mean, it's just straight dropping. I only had the turbo kit because it was like V-band, so it's like a lot easier to work with everything.
Exactly.
It's like unbolt, snatch the turbo up in the four bolt.
Oh, wait a minute. You just bought this?
Yeah. Yeah. So
this was yours?
Yeah.
Oh.
So he put it all together. It's all-wheel drive. This used to be turbo, but it's going to go into this. But this will be fun. I figured, you know, since this is wide body, it should kind of look, it should be all-wheel drive. Like, it looks
you
like
you could definitely fit a wide rim, right?
Yeah.
Nice wide rim entire. As far as the motor, like, I set it up for kill mode, right? I was gonna tilt the motor to 800 horsepower because it's all-wheel drive, which I know I didn't need too much. Right now we got a little hatchback in Brooklyn and we're on an eBay kit, and
I'll be
there
just
killing stuff.
For sure.
Listen, man, this is my baby, man.
I'm gonna take care of it and do as good as I can. But this is
my home.
I'm glad that I got this already situated.
And, you know,
so we built it over 4 days. So GT, VVTi head, valve train is like just whatever, like stage one. Precision turbo, standalone, we did 6-speed, we did twin disc clutch. Just like it was like no sleep for a while. And it just made
the turbo manifold. Right?
That is a CX Racing. So it was has a Greddy intercooler, just a bunch of like parts that, you know, from here and there, some used parts.
64 or 62?
64. 64, 66. Yeah. So it has a CD009.
Red interior.
It's a Nissan gearbox, right?
Yeah. So a 370Z. And it made 683. And that's when we started running out of fuel pump. So, I mean, it'll do 800, but I was happy with 600.
Yeah. 8 is just a number, man.
Yeah. But it, like, you know, it could have made 850 or something, but I didn't want to, like, there's no reason for me to do that. Like, I don't need a million horsepower, you know? Like, you can kill yourself with 500 horsepower. But this is a lot of fun. I really like this car. I got this car when it was completely NA, and man, that thing was slow. We put it on Eric's dyno, actually, and it was, it made 120 horsepower.
Damn.
NA, yeah.
Oh my God.
120 horsepower at the wheels. It was slow, like Camry slow.
Damn.
So bad. So now it made 680, and it's the same engine.
Okay. So, I would not imagine to pull same this engine. NA Supra and it's dual.
Yeah, no, it was slow shit. No, it's fine. This Lexus has a million miles on it.
What?
Yeah, this was given to me by my friend. He bought it at 900,000, and then he gave it to people to like so they could just put miles on it. And then he finally got it to a million. The cluster says 999999, and it just doesn't go any further. But it has the original engine. Everything works in the car. It leaks. It leaks a lot of oil. So I'm gonna take everything out. I'm gonna reseal it. Probably do a restoration on the paint and stuff, and then maybe just take it for another drive across the country, and you know, we'll see. Maybe take it to the museum or something.
When you drive this car, it feels like you're towing a trailer because all the weight's behind you. So you're like, you're steering and it's so light. And it's weird. Like, you don't want to give it too much gas because, you know, like, it's not going to lift, but too much gas on the turn because, like, all the weight's behind you, it's like a engine. You know? But it's like one of the best cars ever. Like, I love driving this thing. The only problem, what I don't like is the fact that it draws so much attention. So there's supposed to be a cooler here, and that like dented here. Cooler came off. One of the turbos, the compressor housing broke. So one of the turbos is bad. Also, one of the ears on the engine for the engine mount, that broke off. So I'm going to have to re-weld that or something, but not a huge deal. Like this.
I'm going to take the motor off.
Yeah. So drop the motor.
You can overwork yourself.
Yeah. So this entire frame has to come out. I have another frame over there. I just found out that the front subframe. I'll show you. Just here. So the front subframe I thought was okay, but then I measured it, and this side is a good 3/8 of an inch shorter than that side. So I need a new one of these. And you can only get them from McLaren, and they're specific to this car. Yeah, that's the carbon tub damage. So yeah, it hit over here too. So it hit the carbon tub. So I'm gonna have to.
Do about that?
Well, you can repair carbon tubs. I mean, they've had carbon tubs in planes for a while, so you know it's basically the same thing.
All right.
It's a pain in the ass though. I mean, you have to vacuum form it and all that stuff. But you know, otherwise you have to take it to the autoclave, which is like this huge like pressure cooker type thing. Mm-hmm. That's how they make these in the beginning.
Okay.
And those are. Like, I mean, I'd have to take literally everything off. But I'm not going to do that. I think that can be, like, spot repair. Like, there's a guy that does carbon fiber bike repairs just down the street, and he can do this. So.
Yeah, I realize it's, like, within this little area.
There's so much.
That's what we don't have.
Oh, yeah.
That's what we don't have.
I used to live in Jersey. I love New Jersey. I know all that shit. So.
You don't have this type of stuff. Same way, like, that.
Yeah. Everything was custom, like just me and another guy in my two car garage, and we just made this. But it's really cool, built engine, you know, makes a ton of power.
But, like close over 1,000, right?
So it's the engine can do 1,600. I have it at like around 9, but it's just like bananas. right now it's rear wheel drive, and it's,
yeah, cause I was looking under and I seen it has no drive shaft.
Yeah, there's no drive shaft. I don't know if I'm going to leave rear wheel drive or all wheel drive.
It's crazy. Yeah. Rear wheel drive.
The problem with these is that, like, you know what Hondas go like, wah, bah, bah, bah. Like this is very gradual, and then you're like, hey, this isn't so bad, and then it was
really bad. So I took it down to the primer, repainted everything. I have this product called Clarity Coat, and it's like a extra clear coat on top, and it's like peelable. So like this car is basically scratch proof. So you can scratch it and you can just like, you know, peel it off. But this is at SEMA, you know, it's going to go to the Peterson Automotive Museum for a year, in LA. So I'm trying to get, Tyrese into the car. The Jay Leno's Garage people wanted to do it, but, since this COVID thing happened, they're like,
everything's slowing down, but,
yeah, we wanted to do something like, oh, you know, we found your car or something like that, and so have him drive it.
That would be dope.
I've been trying to get that set up for a long time.
That would be dope.
I also found the other engine so they use 3 cars for the movie.
Okay.
I found the other car. It's in the UK, but the guy wants too much money for it, so... But I found the engine and transmission and everything else for that car. So that's over here. So that's from the sister car.
Oh,
wow. So I got that engine, you know, just to have. And I'm kind of like holding it hostage because, you know, if that guy wants to rebuild it, like...
He's going to need that.
Yeah, yeah. You're gonna need it, or I'm just going to... He's going to have to sell me.
Sell you the car, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And I think that adds to the value of the car, like, because
yeah,
like it, never be, it can never be,
it would never be the same. V12, yeah,
on the floor. V12 just chilling in your shop.
What's cool is that the transmission in this car goes in front of the engine.
Yeah, so I'm looking at it right now. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yo, this should,
yeah. So this is the back of the engine. Transmission goes in front. There's a drive shaft that goes through, and there's a diff back here. So it's all wheel drive. It's real. It's kind of stupid, but yeah. Like pulling the engine is a pain in the ass.
That's crazy.
I converted this to rear wheel drive, so it's a little bit more fun to drive. So it doesn't, like, the engine is all taken apart, so I have to get to that at some point.
What's up with the Range Rover?
That's my dad's old car. he got a new car, and he said, hey, why don't you fix it and sell it and give me the money? And I was like, sure. And that was like probably a year ago. And I've just been here. And it needs some suspension work and whatever, and I'll just sell it. Nothing, you know. It's a lower mileage car. I think it's like 79,000 miles or something. It's a decent car. I like driving it, but it's, you know, just a regular Range Rover. But I just got this, and it's like the James Bond spec. It's like Casino Royale.
Yeah, whatever.
I got it because it was a manual.
Yeah,
this
thing
is,
I'm just checking it out.
This thing is mean. Wait, where's that Civic?
The Bugatti Civic?
Yeah, the Bugatti Civic. Yeah.
Bugatti Civic?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the Bugatti Civic is mean. You can't tell it's a Civic, bro.
What? Oh, nah.
Dude, this thing is
like, and it's turbo too.
Yeah, when he showed me, I'm like, yo,
dude, this is like the worst car I think I've ever bought. So somebody thought it was Civic a good idea. Guy. Yeah, Civic Guy, dude.
That's the spacer you was telling me about.
You want to, dude?
Holy shit!
Can you imagine driving on that?
What the hell?
That's like super dangerous. That's like
damn really stupid.
So it's extended studs he got in there along with some lug nuts.
I have no idea. I haven't driven it.
Did he even put EK brakes on it?
Yeah, just pulled off the trailer and brought it in here. It leaks so much fuel. Like, it leaks this crazy amount of gas.
With a single jingle.
You like this?
What?
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Dude, like, I mean, somebody paid money to do this.
To do the kid.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody paid some money for this shit.
Yeah. But I was thinking I can take this turbo off. It's a Precision. I don't know what it is. It looks the housing a little small. I can probably put a little bigger housing on it. But it has some like
Good parts.
Yeah, it has some. Yeah, I mean the welding is kind of shitty, but
yeah, the welding is shitty, but it has good parts.
Mm-hmm.
And some money was spent, as you said, like some real good money.
So what I'm thinking of doing is like I'll take out the engine, like I'll get it running and stuff. I'll see what it's actually like, and then I'm going to. I have a friend in Texas, and he has access to a yard where like they have tanks. And I was thinking of shooting this with a tank, or like or something with a tank. Because so, I mean, like this doesn't deserve to live.
Yeah, this is crazy.
But I'll take out the engine. I'll take out some of the stuff in the interior.
Look at the freaking interior on this shit.
Recovered, so it's not too bad. Civic it actually has a 2000 gauge cluster, which I like.
Yeah, that I did like when I seen that. I'm like, okay, the cluster passes over for the interior.
It has some system. Yeah, it has some sound. Like some real old school shit though. Real old school.
Not it.
They got mad amps back there too.
Yeah, that is a lot of old school shit. Definitely. Yeah.
So I mean, you could probably replace all that with like one good amp now.
Yeah, for real.
Damn.
Yeah, he spent some money.
So I got that. We're gonna put those together because this is like a parts car. I got an SR20 for it from like an Infiniti G20. We'll do like a little bit of a sort of hot rod. It's not turbo or anything, but just a little bit more power than this had. Lower it, put some wheels on it, do an exhaust. It's gonna be a cool little car, you know, for like $1,000.
Yeah. That's about it. I have some cars at home. So how much cars you think you have in total?
20 something, maybe I don't know. Depends on, I mean, how many run, right? Like
not even running.
You
own them.
20 something, maybe 21.
Damn. I need to catch up. I need like 19 more.
We need space. We would have cars, but
dude, when I got the space, like it filled up so fast because like I got these lifts. Before these lifts, these cars were like everywhere, and I'm like, I need more space. I got the lifts, and then now it's like, hey, I have all the space. Why don't I get some more stuff? So, but I did work for people, suspension installs, engine installs. Just kind of cut my teeth on that. Yeah, just and charging like nothing, like some crackhead rates, like $80 for suspension.
Because it's a hobby to us, so we don't really care about the money, just the passion. You sit there, you work, and you get the peace of mind while working on the car.
Exactly, yeah. And from there, I started flipping cars. I wasn't very good at it, but like I made some money, so I got into cars like the BMW E46 M3, M5. I had an RX7. I bought all these cars like really, really cheap. Like they're all like really crappy, so they're in non-running condition. I would like fix them up, sell them, maybe make a grand, maybe sometimes a break even, you know, whatever. And then I started writing about it, and then I started I got some offers from some websites to write about it, and then that turned into like somewhat of a job. Like I started doing car reviews, started doing like more articles, that sort of thing. They flew me all around the world for for press launches and stuff like that, and I got to know that world. And then from there I was like, I can do a YouTube channel because I saw other people doing it, So I just started doing YouTube, and then, like, you know, first videos always suck. And, you know, now I think all my stuff sucks. But, you know, you just keep on going.
All the way to Florida. And Fabe with Tavares over there. We just looked at his garage. There's another garage across the street that looked interesting. Had this GTR up front. So we asked if we could go look at it. So he wanted us. He wanted to introduce us. So.
Yeah.
We got two Datsuns back to back.
What?
The Datsun.
Yeah, remember,
you don't
see these
too often in Brooklyn. Yeah, yeah. I don't think you see it. Where in Brooklyn?
Flatbush.
Flatbush?
Oh, holy shit! I thought you guys were like just up the road.
No, no, no.
Holy shit!
You guys. I had a shop on Utica.
Oh yeah,
Utica. What?
I was looking at the Type R2, I seen it. Damn. Carbon fiber. Trips I ever been on. Right now, we're back in Tavares' garage, and like I feel like I just walked back in here again. Look at these toys behind
me.
Look at this. Damn. Look at this.
What? This is what you want to see?
Look at this. Damn, this is like, imagine you wake up one day, this is your garage. Which one are you going to get in first? Damn.